Newlyweds Takashi and Machiko find themselves at the Quindecim bar. The bartender Decim has them stake their lives in a game of darts, where each dart landed causes their partner pain depending on where it lands. As the game progresses, their memories return and Takashi recalls suspecting that Machiko had been having an affair, which she denies. He tries to bend the match in his favor, landing the winning hit. At the end of the game, it is revealed they had both died in a car crash because of Takashi's jealousy, and Machiko subsequently claims that she only married Takashi for his money. After Decim prevents Takashi from further attacking Machiko, he sends them to the elevators. Takashi is reincarnated and Machiko is sent to the void. A black-haired woman with no name or memory is taken by Nona to the Quindecim, where she is assigned to be Decim's assistant. Nona takes the woman backstage to observe the darts game between Machiko and Takashi, explaining the nature behind the games. After the game's conclusion, the woman expresses her thoughts, believing that Machiko only had a one-time fling which she regretted and was lying about her baby's father in order to save Takashi's soul. This comes as a surprise to Decim, who is apologetic about being possibly mistaken in his judgment. Later, Nona is seen reading a children's book titled Chevaux in a separate house. Two new amnesiac teenagers arrive in the Quindecim for another game. This game chosen involves 10-pin bowling. The balls contain each other's hearts, which each pulse according to its owner's feelings. As the game goes on, the two become friendly and begin to recall portions of their memories. The boy recalls that he is a college student named Shigeru Miura, and the girl recalls that she was a girl named Chisato Miyazaki who was once childhood friends with Shigeru before moving away. Shigeru then remembers both he and Chisato died whilst on a bus together, while Chisato also recalls more of the truth about herself. After winning the match, Shigeru asks Chisato for a short date together with what time they have left. They part ways at the elevators, happy to have had a chance to spend time with one another. It is then revealed that Chisato was actually Shigeru's other childhood friend Mitakata, who underwent plastic surgery to look like Chisato in order to catch Shigeru's eye. They are both sent to be reincarnated. A teenager named Yusuf Tatishi and a TV celebrity named Misaki Tachibana arrive in the Quindecim. Misaki is convinced that they are on a hidden camera show and asks Yusuf to behave accordingly. The two participate in an arcade fighting game, playing as fighters based on themselves. Yusuk wins the first round while Misaki experiences a flash of memories of abusive partners. She asks Yusuk to let her win the next round, during which Decim triggers a device causing Yusuk's joystick to malfunction. Misaki wins the second round while Yusuk experiences his own flash of memories about his troubled childhood. They realize that they are not on a TV show, and Misaki becomes paranoid that she will be killed if she loses. Misaki uses a special move, but Decim causes her joystick to malfunction, explaining that it is necessary to expose a soul's darkness and past judgment. Desperate to win, Misaki physically attacks Yusuk and knocks him unconscious. Despite Misaki's remorse over her actions, Decim forces her to continue playing the game. Yusuk regains consciousness and fights back with his own special move, with the match ending in a double knockout. Afterwards, they both realize they had died, Yusuk having committed suicide while Misaki was killed by her angered assistant. Decim sends Yusuk to be reincarnated while Misaki is sent to the void. The black-haired assistant has been having a recurring dream about a boy and a girl and is surprised to find the same girl on a panel. Nona asks Decim to put behind the bar. Two new guests, a man and a young boy, arrive at the bar. Decim is taken aback when the man recalls having been there before and becomes violent. As Decim restrains the man, both the man and Decim's assistant are put to sleep by the young boy, who is revealed to be another arbiter in disguise named Jinty. Jinty accuses Decim of not judging his assistant even though she is dead. Jinty attacks Decim over his insubordination, but they are stopped by Nona, who reveals the guests were part of a test for Decim. She explains that Decim failed to realize the boy had no memories because he was distracted by the man, who was a dummy implanted with memories. Later, as the assistant dreams again about the boy and girl called Jimmy and Chevaux, Nona is seen again reading the book titled Chevaux with the same children on its cover. Mayu Arata, an overexcited schoolgirl, and Harada, a member of a popular boy band, arrive at the Arbiter bar run by Jinty, who has them play a game of Twister. While Mayu is excited to play with someone from her favorite band, Harada is more concerned with getting back to his girlfriend. When Mayu and Harada demand a break, Jindy changes up the game, causing the climate of the game mat to change with each different panel they step on, from heating to freezing cold. Suddenly Mayu and Harada are put in a sudden death situation above a pit of spikes. Just as Harada is about to push Mayu off to save himself, Mayu decides to forfeit and lets herself drop. Harada grabs her, feeling guilty over driving one of his ex-girlfriends to suicide. Mayu lets go to save him, but she lands safely on rubber spikes instead of dying. Mayu then remembers that she died after slipping on some soap, while Harada recalls he was killed by his girlfriend in revenge for the suicide of her sister, who was his ex-girlfriend. Later, Harada takes an interest in Mayu after she changes into a kimono, and together they perform a concert for the Arbiter staff. The assistant comes across the Chevaux book containing the same story which occurs in her dreams, causing her to regain some memories and to realize that she is dead. When she asks Desim about the book, he tells her it belongs to Quinn, the Quindesim's former arbiter. In a flashback to Desim's training, Nona questions him over why he did not use his remote device to affect the outcome while observing one of Quinn's death games. He replied that he respects those who had lived full lives, which intrigued Nona. Quinn has since become part of the Information Bureau after quitting her job as arbiter. While drinking with Nona, Quinn comments on how Desim is an unusual arbiter with human emotions. Meanwhile, Desim shows his assistant his treasure, a collection of dummies dressed like former guests who were sent to the void. He does this so they would not be completely disposed of and forgotten. Later, Nona arranges for two special guests to be sent to Desim. As per Nona's request, Desim is sent two new guests, a young man named Shimada and a detective named Tatsumi, one of whom is allegedly a murderer. While searching for a way out, Shimada finds a bloodstained knife among his belongings, unsure of where it came from. As the two guests participate in a game of air hockey, Shimada gradually regains memories of looking after his younger sister, while Tatsumi remembers that his wife was murdered. With the two regaining further memories that fuel their motivations to escape, with Shimada remembering his sister was assaulted, Desim changes up the game, in which scored pucks deal pain to the respective players' organs. Meanwhile, the black-haired woman makes a request to see the memories that Desim received and learns that both Shimada and Tatsumi are murderers. As the game between Shimada and Tatsumi continues, Shimada realizes he has already killed someone, the man who assaulted his sister Sae. Tatsumi also remembers that he had killed his wife's murderer and remembers that Shimada was the one who killed him. It appears that Tatsumi had watched Sae be assaulted so that he would have enough evidence to pass judgment on her attacker. On the other hand, Shimada believed that Tatsumi was a passive accomplice in Sae's assault and stabbed him to death. Desim gives Shimada the opportunity to exact punishment on Tatsumi by stabbing the pucks containing Tatsumi's organs. However, his assistant objects and asserts that he cannot judge people's souls based on their memories alone. She tries to stop Shimada from punishing Tatsumi, but Shimada gives into his anger and kills him. Desim is taken aback by his assistant's arguments, as she maintains that people are more complex than they appear on the surface, suggesting that both Shimada and Tatsumi were sent to the void. Desim begins to question his ability to judge people following the previous game. Nona reminds him that he still needs to judge his assistant because she will turn into a dummy if she goes without judgment. He decides against having her memories sent to him, and Nona sends him a new guest, an old illustrator named Sachiko Uemura. Desim, the assistant, and the woman play old maid using cards featuring designs based on things which are important to them. Based on images they see, Sachiko deduces she has died, while the assistant recalls that her name is Chiyuki after Sachiko tells them about the feelings of the children in the Chevaux story. As Sachiko politely leaves to be reincarnated, Nona's boss Oculus absorbs the memories of Clavis the elevator attendant and learns that Desim is displaying human emotions. Meanwhile, Nona has Quinn retrieve Chiyuki's memories. Mayu and Harada have not yet been sent on and are still in Jindy's bar. Jindy gives Mayu the opportunity to choose another human soul to be sent into the void in exchange for Harada, who is unconscious. Concurrently, Desim asks Chiyuki to perform some ice skating, having noticed it was a large part of her memories. As she skates, Chiyuki regains her memories in which she used to be a professional ice skater until a severe knee injury forced her to retire. This led her to become severely depressed and kill herself. Desmond and Chiyuki have a final drink together, but he puts her to sleep and then asks Quinn to send him her memories. Meanwhile, Mayu has decided to stay with Harada and share his fate rather than sacrifice another person in his place. Jindy questions her devotion to Harada, and she just says it is her choice. He sends them off in the elevator together, and as they turn into dummies, Harada wakes up, enabling them to have a last embrace before entering the void. Oculus confronts Nona's methods as she wants to prove that arbiters are more than dummies. Desmond shows Chiyuki her old house, where she sees that her mother still cares for her, causing her to regret taking her own life. Desmond offers Chiyuki a chance to return home in exchange for another's life, and she comes close to taking up the offer. However, upon remembering how everyone she met in the Quindecim had people who cherished them, she ultimately decides against it. This causes powerful and painful emotions to swell up in Desmond, who reveals to Chiyuki that this was part of her judgment. Nona observes the outcome with Oculus, demonstrating that an important part of being able to judge humans is to understand their suffering. Desmond sees Chiyuki off to be reincarnated, vainly attempting to smile. Nona and the others' arbiters ponder the implications to their system if arbiters begin understanding human behavior. Later, Desmond welcomes new guests to the Quindecim with a barely perceptible smile, while the bar now contains a mannequin made up to look like Chiyuki. So this is the end of anime. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed it.